So
I'll show you how to put on the flyees. At the rear of the heel, it says step. So all you do is step onto that. That releases the mechanism, and you just slide your foot in and pull the heel up after you're finished getting in, getting comfy, adjusting the shoe. Then you see this this tag here. It says lock. All you do, you give that a quick pull. You hear audible click, and that's the shoe tightened and locked into place. To release the shoe, all you do, you pull this cord that says release. Hear that audible click again. Step on your heel, and then you just slide your foot out. The construction of the shoe, the frame, the locking lever, it's all built into the heel. You do notice it at first, but once you get running and whatever, it's quite comfortable. There's quite a lot of padding around the heel. The tongue's very well padded as well. There's two air zoom pockets at the front. And it's overall, it's a comfortable tempo shoe. It is heavier than the original tempo shoe. However, it's still very comfortable. And it's a joy to wear. And it comes in this lovely colour of health and safety. You can see me running for miles, a luminous yellow or green, whatever colour it is. So, yeah. I'm not sure if they make them or sell them anymore, as they were a bit of a gimmick. But I quite enjoy running it today. Right, peeps, I'll leave it there for now. Thanks for watching. Hello, peeps, so it's Friday. Feeling a lot better than what I was last week, put it that way. So a bit of a slow start back into running, but I'm getting there. So I'm just doing a nice steady run today. So this week's mile has just been did a 14 miler, did 9 and 8, a rest day, can't quite remember what I did yesterday, 7-6 mile, about 7 mile yesterday, a strength session at gym, and today is going to be around 7 miles, I think. Taking it nice and easy still, not pushing pace just yet. However, yesterday I did push it a wee bit in places, enjoyed it. So I'm wearing the Nike Next Percent Easy On, Easy Off. The Nike mechanical shoe. I do a short review on them. Not too bad. Heavy, but you can feel the contraption inside the shoe. It's a laceless system. You step on the heel to so you can get into the shoe, and then you pull on the tog to tighten it to however tight you want it, then off you pop. And then when you finish your run, you pull on the release cord and then you just slip your feet out of them. A bit of a gimmick, but a comfy shoe anyhow. Just add a wee bit of weight to them, so I won't be racing them. And they're coming a nice colour. I don't think they make them anymore.
I don't think they're on sale anymore, so there they are. I'll just slow down. Like I said, I do a little bit of a review on them. Bought them last year for about 80 quid, I think they were. When they first came out, about 200 quid, or not far off. It's a bit windy today, it's quite warm, but windy. So there is a little bit of a chill in the air, which is quite welcome. Helps to cool you down a wee bit. I'll leave it there for this segment and I'll catch up with you later. Still struggling to talk and run. Small gains, and I'm sure I'll get there like British Rail in the end. And just on the outskirts of town now. There's a gym there that we go to, JD's gym. So I've just went down North Road into town. And then Victoria and Bankland through the train station. Up the Arm Road, and the left Mottland Road, and then back at right, back home. A bit of resistance, trading. As you can tell, I still can't. Talk with more sort of behind on my face a wee bit. Well, quite a lot. So that's it. 5 miles done. Just getting this hill section done. And then another hill section. Last week when I did this, I had to stop here to recover some walk all the way down there just to catch my breath. So this is a good measure. See how well I've recovered so far. But I ain't setting the pavements on fire this year. Too bad. Just keep them going. Keep them going. Ammunition. So tomorrow I'm not sure. I'm going to be running or resting tomorrow. Because I need to serious ring timing. Getting ready for the wall 2023. Adrian's wall ultra. So we've put the shirt on time rather than distance at first, and then increase the distance, work out the shoes, nutrition, start carrying what I'm gonna be carrying on the day. The kit list. We've got to wait. Yeah, there's a lot to do. Shoes, pace, equipment. Can't just turn up one day and put it all on and hope for the best. You know, the planning prevents piss poor performance. Now I'm on a bed. New cinemas. Just don't indicate. Alright, peeps, leave it there for now. Catch up with you later. It's alright. I'm doing peak, so I'm on my last mile now. 7 miles done, so 7 out of 1 equals 8. Look at that, I've been back twice in a week. Been back yesterday and last today. It's been a tempo run. Get it done, keep the legs turning. Keep you a nice, very consistent pace. Hopefully I'll get a little bit faster. Or this might be my chosen pace for a comfortable ultra. We'll see. But we all know there's nothing comfortable about ultras. I'm not pig-headed. And I'm not... what's the word? I don't know. Not overconfident or anything like that. It's going to be hard. It's going to be mentally hard and physically hard. Anyhow, we'll see how we do up there. 28th of January, I got my first race. Head torch race at Dolby Forest. I think it's only a short one. But we're at night time in January. We'll be on trails, will be a whole new experience. Much trippage, I reckon. Right peeps, thanks for watching, I'll catch you later.